My album is called Manic, and I wrote it kind of as like a study of all of these different emotions and perspectives that I was having through the process of making the record. But what was really important to me was making sure that it was also educational. And so that's why we're sitting down today, is because I really want to give my audience who maybe doesn't know that much about bipolar disorder a chance to better understand it, maybe learn a few things or discover some resources and perspectives. So that's why we're here. So thank you for doing this. For anyone who's watching who doesn't know, what is bipolar disorder?
So bipolar disorder is a mood disorder where people have two phases, typically two phases. It's a cyclical pattern of mood changes marked by depression, which is, you know, the low phase where you're feeling sad, low energy, and the manic phase, which is usually high energy.
Yeah.
People usually feel well, but that's also a myth.
Yeah.
You can actually feel manic and still feel depressed or sad at the same time.
Or aggressive.
Or aggressive and don't know how to direct your energy. Mm-hmm. Sometimes it takes 6 months, sometimes it can take 10 years to diagnose somebody with bipolar disorder.
A lot of people will say, you know, you don't seem like you have bipolar disorder because, you know, of the ways in which that I function. Because they see a young woman who's like achieving all of these goals and they think, well, there really can't be anything hindering her from that.
Yes.
But before I had music, especially in my adolescence, I was a very different person than the person that I am now because I didn't have resources. I had been committed in my late adolescence when I was first diagnosed. And so when I put out my second record, I started to notice those feelings, you know, kind of creeping back in slowly and then all at once. And I said to some of the people around me, I said, it's not that bad right now, but I can recognize that if I don't act on it, it will become that way. So I'd started doing therapy after, which I hadn't been doing at that point. A year and a half later, I had a similar occurrence around manic, where I had finished the project and I went back to that place where I was like, well, what now? And I had learned from the last experience, and instead of even getting to a point where I thought I needed some kind of intervention, I was able to stop myself and go, this is going to pass. If I could have asked you any question when I was 16 or 17 and you know, kind of around the time of my diagnosis, I think the question probably would have been, how do I know what I'm allowed to feel?
First of all, everybody with any mental health illness, you are entitled to whatever you're feeling.
That's great. Oh my God, I said that.
And I want you to be validated for it. Mm-hmm. Although you don't have to justify it. Why do I feel this way? We want to first learn to deal with it, be able to seek help, and be able to not worry about carrying that burden of what others would think.
Yeah, and policing your emotions.
Policing your own thoughts, policing your own behavior. Everybody's disease is slightly different. And sometimes you are able to take control of those, and sometimes you cannot. And it's important to understand for all the young people out there to understand that mental illness is real, but at the same time, it is something you can deal with and have a very functional life around.
You know, sometimes I find for me, it's like, the media is very celebratory of mental illness when they're getting something out of it. When it's like, you know, oh, the art that she makes or the this or the that, you know. But then if it takes something from them, if I can't do a show or if I can't do an appearance, then it becomes weaponized in that way. The way that they can take the narrative away from you after you've chosen to share it is what's one of the most terrifying parts is like, you know, I mean, I worry about the way my mental illness will affect situations that are completely unrelated to it, you know? Like, I've had situations where I've had, a sore throat and I've wanted to cancel a concert. And then I get that fear of, well, everyone's just gonna say, well, she's crazy, she's probably having a breakdown, or she's unreliable, or she's whatever. I think that our culture, in a way, has an obsession and a distaste for the crazy woman. We love her, but we also weaponize that word against her.
The pixie dream girl kind of picture has been, I would say it's created by the media, by the pop culture. The mania and the depression exist, but they have been exaggerated. The way they've been presented is such an exaggerated version. Mm-hmm. Mental health illness does affect women slightly more in certain stages because of their hormonal cycle.
Eliminating the stigma around mental health, it kind of spider webs into this whole other social conversation about letting people be who they are. You know, fighting toxic masculinity and allowing men to feel emotions, and therefore if they can feel their emotions, they'll feel, you know, more comfortable talking about what they're going through and then maybe get a mental health diagnosis and have a better life. Allowing women to be less than perfect and less than ideal and poised and composed so that they can reach a diagnosis and therefore have a better life. Accepting members of the LGBT community and offering them comfort and guidance and community so that they can feel comfortable talking about their mental illness, because it's not just another thing on the list. Just let people be who they are. In a perfect world, that would be how we
could
get to the root of it. I mean, there's nothing more devastating than putting yourself out there and wanting to connect with someone and then them not accepting you for who you are. Meeting a partner in an episode and then when I'm not manic anymore, them being like, well, now you're this depressed, miserable thing and that's not what I signed up for. Or, you know, someone meeting me when I am, you know, in a period of stability and then having a manic episode and then being like, what is this? What is going on?
You expecting something and not getting that in reciprocation can happen in any relationship, but it happens more so if you have a mental health disorder, especially one that's cyclical. It's okay to express yourself and it's okay to tell people around you about your needs, just like everybody else does.
Yeah.
So living with that kind of transparency actually gives you the ability to be able to say, hey, listen, this is what I am as a whole. And this is going to change. This may change in a few weeks or a few months. And living with that kind of acceptance and not taking it upon yourself or not blaming yourself for this is the most important thing.
When I got my diagnosis, the first thing people around me did was apologize. The second thing that everybody did was tell me all of the things I wouldn't be able to do. And it was, I mean, it was pretty devastating. In retrospect, I look back on it now and I go, okay, well, that was the moment actually where my life changed and I realized what I could do. So I want to ask you, what can people who don't have mental illnesses do to help as well?
Yeah, so it's three words. It's acceptance, acceptance, acceptance. I know it's the same word said three times, but that's really what it is. It's just first to be able to accept that somebody around them can have mental illness. It could be somebody very high functioning. It could be somebody young. It could be somebody old. The other acceptance is accept that they will need help. Mm-hmm. The third acceptance would be that this will recur. So it's not going away.
Yes.
And this is something that will have to be dealt with. And that acceptance that it's not going away takes the longest. So all those people who were apologizing to you, maybe they did not know how to react. Or they may be coming from a place of ignorance. Because yes, most of the people who get the diagnosis are usually relieved. And they're a lot of what they were experiencing now has a label. Per se, and they know where to start. So maybe you want to ask them, so how do you feel
how
now?
How do you feel?
Can I help you in some way?
So
it's all about giving the control back to our patients is what our job is. And once you reach that level, all you can do is help others, and that's exactly what you're doing.
Manic for me was a celebration. Because for a long time, I had really struggled with my mania. It was the worst part of me. I considered that girl, the manic one, I considered her irresponsible and untrustworthy, unreliable. She spoke too loud. She had a million ideas and couldn't get any of them done. And in the process of making this album, I had to kind of make peace with this manic version of myself and sit down and think, you know, when I'm manic, that's also when I make my best art. It's when I'm the most compassionate. It's the version of me that has given me everything that I have. And so, you know, part of this record process was almost writing her a love letter. I am nervous, but yes. I also know how important this is, and I so desperately want things to change and to get better. That was the point of all of this.
Yes.
Was to give people a place to start the conversation. I've always said to myself, as my general mantra, that mental health, achieving mental health, that doesn't happen. Mental health isn't a destination. You never arrive at mentally healthy and then go, okay, I'm glad I got here. That took a lot of work. It's a perpetual journey. It takes constant care and attention and energy. And sometimes it's really good. Sometimes it's really bad, but it's perpetual.
And outcomes change. Mm-hmm. I mean, people think, you know, we're on this journey alone, and it's very important for them to realize that they're not alone in this journey. Mm-hmm. And what makes each one of these journeys so unique sometimes is the people around them. Mm-hmm. And so just uplift each other, mm-hmm. Listen to each other. And I think that's the first step that mm-hmm. we can all take. Yes. Definitely.